Good morning, welcome to Caddx TV. My name is Frank Fortunato. Today is Tuesday, April 8th, 2014. The Lloyd's Syndicate Atrium has been in the news recently. They are on the policy for the missing Malaysian aircraft, Malaysian Flight 370. They hold the war policy on the missing plane, meaning that they would have to pay in the event of terrorism. Since the plane's disappearance has not yet been discerned as to why, Malaysia's policy claims have been being paid 50-50 by the war policy people led by Atrium, as well as the all-risk policy, which is being led by Allianz. Meanwhile, the underwriters who underwrote that risk for Atrium have left. They walked out en masse yesterday, resigning 6 months after Atrium had been acquired by the runoff carrier Enstar. Departures followed weeks of speculations that Atrium would suffer defections once the staff bonuses were paid on April 1st. Underwriters apparently refused to adjust to the changed perceptions of the business after Atrium was acquired by a runoff carrier. Speaking of Malaysian Airlines Flight 370, the American Navy has now corroborated that those signals picked up by the Chinese Navy, in fact, are consistent with the missing black boxes. It's supposedly the most promising lead to date. There's still no word as to if, in fact, they have located the boxes. There was a significant earthquake in southeastern France last night. A 5.2 struck down the area of Provence and Monte Carlo in Nice. The quake was felt as far away as Turin in Italy. There was some shaking right in Monte Carlo in the casino area. French seismologists are saying this is just a prelude to the quote-unquote big one. There are a number of areas in the world apparently waiting for big ones. A Florida primary insurance company has decided to reduce its exposure in southern Florida to hurricane risk. It's canceling thousands of policyholders in anticipation of the June 1st opening of the hurricane season. The company is called People's Trust Insurance Company. They're canceling 5% of their homeowners policies. They have 115,000 homeowners policies, so they're canceling about 5% of that. It's approximately 6,300 people. People's Trust Insurance Company is a new insurance company, a so-called takeout carrier, taking business out of the common mechanism through depopulation. And in January, the company had been awarded a prize by the Florida Governor Rick Scott as the winner of the Enterprise Florida Governor's Innovators for Business Award. They've decided that they don't want to have that risk down in Dade County. Ballantyne McKeon and Sullivan, BMS, the big London broker and managing general agent, is apparently in the market looking to raise capital. Sources are saying that they've appointed an investment banker. The company is now being led by Dane Doté, the former Brit CEO, who apparently has a 5% stake in the company. They're looking for new capital to support investment in the fast-growing managing general agency platform they have called Pioneer. In a little tracked election last night up in Quebec, it seems that the separatists suffered a crushing defeat. A snap election had been called in which the separatists, who had led a minority government, hoped to solidify their position, but in fact they were thrown out. There were apparently fears among the Quebecois population that the strengthening of the separatist party would lead to yet another national referendum on secession, which nobody had a taste for. You can be sure that the insurance industry and reinsurance industry is pleased with this news. Here's some news about SUVs. Apparently, most SUVs did not fare well in a new small overlap front crash test conducted by the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety. Chevrolet Equinox, the GMC Terrain from GM, were the only vehicles to earn a rating of good. Toyota Motor Company's Highlander was rated acceptable, while the others, such as the Honda Pilot and the Mazda Motor CX-9, sustained significant structural collapse. 12 people have been killed and 35 injured in a bomb blast on a train in Pakistan's Baluchistan province. It broke out, a fire broke out after the explosion on the Jaffer Express near the southwestern city of Sibi earlier today. No group has thus claimed responsibility yet. However, yesterday, the Pakistani government claimed that it killed 10 Baluch separatists in an operation by security forces in Baluchistan. On Sunday evening, there was a plane crash down in Florida. We noticed it, but it didn't seem to be important enough to put on the news, although two people unfortunately were killed. But apparently, the plane was involved in shooting a scene for a movie, a so-called zombie movie called What Tomorrow Brings. The plane was involved in a shooting down by the Summerfield Airport in Central Florida by Ocala. There were apparently 30 to 50 extras on the site for the low-budget film. In an eerie presage of the night's tragedy, the film's creators described Sunday's planned scene on Facebook as, quote, an explosive airplane finale sequence. He said, the writing said, there will be planes, there will be guns, and of course, zombies. The film's director, Darian Mosley, wrote that filmmakers plan to debut their finished movie by the summer. It's not known whether the finished product will include footage of the actual plane crash. That's the news for today. If we have any breaking news, we'll come back and tell you. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you tomorrow.